man, you protect her. And see, that was Islam.
So what you're saying then, as I understand it, is that in order for us as a community to become what we must become, we're going to have to start with commerce, with business.
Right.
In other words, are you saying that we are already...
We're already standing in position to move, but we got to forget about the lie we've been told. We got men like yourself, men like Imam Muhammad, myself. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad gave to us a pie made from navy beans. And his son had made the most beautiful pie I ever seen in my life. It was until I made it. It was a bean pie. And I went to him because I knew him and he knew me. And I said, Captain Muhammad, I said, your nephew told me you made that pie. He said, oh, what? And he said, the bakery. He said, I'm over the bakery. He said, I want the recipe. He said, you want the recipe? He said, the recipe is in the cookbook. I said, but mine won't come out like that. He says, in there, like that. He said, I'm going to tell you something my father told me. He said, you can tell the nature of the Muslim by the bean pie he made. And right now, I make 9 bean pies. Don't nobody else make 9. And every last one of them, when I put them on the market and go out to sell them, I don't come back with none. And people ask for them. Give me one of this type, one of that type. Give me this, give me that, you know. And I found that to be, you know.
I think, you know, since we are talking about growth and development and these types of things, when it comes to a community of people who have been in the environment of trade and commerce since the inception of the community, what would cause these people, from your pioneering experience, what would cause these people to move now? Something has got to. I mean, basically what I'm hearing you say is that the community already has the religious properties, spiritual properties, to launch a successful business or environment. Does that make sense to you?
In a sense, yes. We are ready, brother, in every big city to do something, but I think it was Malik said one time, said, it's only Allah who say he Allah is one, the only one, and the beginning, and there's none like it. And I think it was Malcolm who was teaching once and said that. Said, so you don't have to get ready. But matter of fact, the brother said something similar to it today. You don't have to get ready or do nothing. You got an email. We got a businessman here. We got other men here want to do things. But if they want to learn and don't know what they're doing, let's get some classes going in. And let's give a brother to teach us how to establish the business, let's unite together, and look how you went to school. You went to school and learned the things you learned. All right, then we got money. Hey man, we got to have money. We sneak down to the thing down there where the people spend the money. Yep, you know, and so many other things, but we can put the money in this community. Just don't worry about I. Let me tell you what, brother. Everybody used to come in my bakery and say, man, y'all got the best pies. And the fellas thought that the bakery was owned by the Muslims. They go in the grocery store we had in Boston. And they do it right now. I can take you up there. They go in the grocery store right now and it's owned by some brothers and the mosque. See? So, and we had a big restaurant. I don't know what they still got. It was twice as big as this. And people used to be jammed in there. See, you got it already. Like I said, see, but you got to listen to your eyes, like the brother said today, so you can see what's going on. And your ears, so you can hear what's going on. One thing was about us in Boston, Brother Talut. It didn't matter with us who the boss were. Because we tell the boss, say, if you don't know what you're doing, ask so we can be successful. And Minister Farrakhan, you know, he owned no business, but he was a builder, brother. And Captain Java took me with the brothers. They had restaurants and things, they start not producing like they should normally. And he says, y'all take Isaiah here. He said, Izzah, take him and tell him what your problem is. He said, clean to show you how to, and it was simple. Wasn't eating the food right. None of them were, because they didn't know. So these things like this here, you know, we had a brother who was from, I don't forget where it was now, but he was a fruit and vegetable man. He had about 4 or 5 fruit stands. And people thought the fruit stand belonged to somebody else. And it belonged to him, but the people invested in him, and they worked for one another, you know, they worked like that. And the same thing with the brother had the shoe store there.
As a pioneer, one of our best pioneers, actually one of them, and who is a historian as well, what do you think would happen to our community if we just, if we don't?
Tell me this here. I'm just going to show you something. If you don't put no water on a flower sitting on this table, what happens to it? That's right. That's what's going to happen to the community. If you can't feed yourself, if you can't clothe yourself, if you can't listen to your leader, if we listen, you say, oh man, you don't know what he's talking about. Yeah, if you don't know, then let's tell him. Since you know you don't know, tell us how to do it. See, this is, you know me, so I was better than most of that. If you know that's me, you know if I don't know how, I'll ask how to do it. And don't tell me, well, you don't know how. But you need to get this and get that. I know this here. If I ask you for advice, and you claim you know everything, give me some advice.
Let me ask you this, Dr. Brock.
Yes, sir.
What about a community that can go outside of the community and get the things that it needs? Is there a success in that?
And you're saying like a community of men can get the things that it takes to cause the community to grow?
No, I'm saying this. Mm-hmm. Maybe I am saying that. Because, yeah, I guess that's exactly what I'm saying. Okay. Instead of producing everything within the community, among ourselves, we go out and purchase what we got to have and bring it back to the community. We don't produce anything. We purchase what we need to consume
right.
And bring it back.
But right, that's a good thing. Mm-hmm. See, because you, but what you should do is take about 10% of anything you purchase and try to produce with it. See, a man who it was one of the, I don't know where I got it from now, but it said if you take a man and buy him a fish, that you can feed him one time. But if you bought a man a fishing pole, give him some warning, and everything, and he would learn how to fish for himself. See, that's the same thing this is. Hey, if you see a man got corn out there and you raising sheep, you know, you gotta buy the corn from somebody. Get with him and say, look, man, I said, I got it 300 head of sheep. 25 head of them belong to you. You doing 25, 30 acres of corn and stuff, you know, wheat and stuff like this here. Right. You say, you give me enough to carry me through the winter with my sheep and things, and I'll give you enough meat that you have, so when spring breaks, we'll have something to over, and then we can start over, mm-hmm. and that just like they start, mm-hmm. and keep going.
You know this better than almost anybody. And here's a question. Historically, men who are businessmen or entrepreneurs, and men who work on jobs have always collided, okay, in conflict, okay, about the direction we need to go into, the future that we need to take, and these types of things, okay. What can we do in our community to bring some reconciliation or bring about some unity of mind with those of us who are business individuals and those who are employed individuals?
You know, a man who is a working man, mm-hmm. this is why America call him blue collar or something like that.
Blue collar, white
collar. Yeah. Hey, they don't want to do the work in the building. But he got a man over them, they say he's a white collar man. You see, they get to arguing and they'll start fighting. But the man over them, they get to arguing and he gets up and say, now, if you don't want your job, you go about your business. And so on and so on. So he's a builder. He's an architect. He might not be called one, but he know how to get things done. See, and this is what it takes. You're going to always have, as long as you have, what do you call it when you take people and make this one lesser than that one over there? No, not ministry.
Maybe I used the wrong word.
Yeah.
Ministry
yeah.
do good things.
Here's a guy. I told you the minister used to, minister was here. Divide.
Divide and conquer.
A man who divides and conquer. Go to the cotton fields and look at the way he make cotton. Some of them they call him sharecroppers. And they call him sharecroppers because he do a certain amount of work with his children. He got a big enough family for himself, but he worked for the boss. He keeps these people here going. And we don't have to do that if they will listen to the knowledge that is offered them. And then we'll get together, and you gotta trust somebody to pick a leader. See, this is why they don't get nowhere. They don't believe God can do it. They can't do it, and they talk about the people who try to do it. So this is the part, you see, in that. But get the man down and tell him, say, we're gonna make sweet potatoes. They said, we could make tomatoes too. And they said, we're going to make sweet potatoes. You know? They tell you about the dude who started the soybean thing going. They say the boll weevil was eating the cotton up. And they couldn't get rid of the boll weevil. But one along and say, hey, they got some soybeans they raised and so on and so on. Go play. Said, and the boll weevil don't even eat them. I'm sorry.
What?
All in one thing. Yes, sir.
So, do we have, as a community of people, you know, not only here in Matthew or Muslim Union, but also across the country, do we have a chance? Are we going to get there? I mean,
got to get there. Can't let them stop it. I mean, it looks like something can, but can't nothing stop us. I'm bound for the higher ground. Good Lord, I'm bound. That's one of the songs. It's so high. They can't get away from this, see? You can't get over it. It's so low, you can't go under it. It's so wide, you can't go around it. You got to come in at the gate and go to work. The black woman, she could start doing a lot of things to bring about money. The sewing, man, you know. Look at the dresses and things they wear now on the kind of our women did what the Honorable Muhammad said, but they didn't keep doing it for themselves. Sold the talent. Boss of the boss wife, she made all of her clothes. And the sisters in the nation just want clothes just about. She was here before she died. See, you got this. And right in here, you got people's consultants. But they won't, they say, well, I just have a job here, so I rest. You ain't put here to rest. You put here to work. And this is what we're put here for. You can teach your children how to work. You know, you got a wife? She said, well, I don't want no job, Dad. You got one. Teach my children how to cook, how to sew, my daughters how to cook, how to sew, how to be good wives for men. They're sitting around talking about he ain't this, he ain't that, ain't that one over there, good looking and everything. Teach them to do something for self. And your son? Oh, when he gets to be 12 years old, like the Jew said, we might do it to him. Since we done found out, you can work on him when he's a month old. And you know, so many things. But we got what we need, Brother Talut. All we have to do is go to work on
it. What do you hope to see come about? Our community here in across the country.
Well, first thing is going to happen. It's going to be a falling away. It's going to be a falling away, brother. It's a whole lot of people going, and then they're going to put it on the people, on us who stay and work and do around. Because see, it's here. Everything is here. It's, I heard Brother Imam teaching one time, and he said, was teaching about how a tree come up out of the ground and push down and shoot up. This is the same thing with us, man. I mentioned sweet potatoes. You know sweet potatoes is one of the greatest sales here? And do you know, I asked my brother-in-law, and he told me to come on and do it 8 years ago about raising some butternut squash. And now butternut squash, you can't keep up. See, this is what we do. We find something other, man.